More than a century ago, one Minnesota lawmaker defined being a groundbreaker. His amazing story has largely been forgotten over the years, though. Joe Mazin takes a look back in this week's So Minnesota.
This beautiful building served as the first University of Minnesota Law School. If the walls could talk here, they could tell you about another first. A young man who stood on these steps would leave his mark on the state. He was in the class of 1894, far from front and center. Actually, you could barely see him in the back row. His name, J. Frank Wheaton.
Very, very few people know about what he did.
Hamline University philosophy professor Sam Imbo tells us Wheaton's groundbreaking impact on Minnesota has largely been forgotten.
History has not been kind to the memory of people like Frank Wheaton. We are losing a lot by not knowing about them.
Born and raised on the East Coast, Wheaton was the first African American to graduate from the University of Minnesota Law School, and only the fourth to earn a degree from the university.
He was educated, he was trained, he was interested in public life, and so he was interested in making things better.
After graduating, Wheaton was hired as an assistant file clerk for the Minnesota House of Representatives. A few years later, he ran on the Republican ticket to represent the Kenwood District of Minneapolis. The district had an estimated 9,000 voters, fewer than 50 whom were black. Wheaton won the election, becoming the first African American to serve in the Minnesota Legislature.
So if you work out the numbers, the election of J. Frank Wheaton was not by black people.
After Wheaton was refused service at a Minneapolis restaurant, he introduced an amendment to a bill that prevented businesses from refusing service to anyone on the basis of race or color. The bill was signed into law by Governor John Lind in 1899.
So he's kind of is backed into working for civil rights issues because these were really important for him. He cared about those things, but the personal experience just pushed him a little bit more.
Wheaton did not run for re-election in 1900. Instead, he went to Chicago to help start the United Brotherhood, an insurance company open to people of all races.
Later, Wheaton continued his law career in New York City. In 1922, he put up a high-priced bail bond for one of his clients who escaped town. Facing financial ruin, Wheaton committed suicide. He was 55 years old.
So if you think about the NAACP, people like Roy Wilkins, people like Martin Luther King, they're going to build up on the things that J. Frank Wheaton has already started. So the important figures in history are really important, but the forgotten figures are sometimes even more important.
All those years ago, he may have stood in the back row, but J. Frank Wheaton's accomplishments should always remain front and center. In Minneapolis, Joe Mazin, 5 Eyewitness News.